Okay, so in this lesson, we're going to learn how pollen grains and embryo sac are formed in plants. We'll look at how pollen grain nuclei can get to the embryo sac, and we're also going to outline the events that lead to a triploid endosperm and zygote forming inside the embryo sac. So first, you need to know your flower anatomy. Now, a lot of people think you might get male flowers and female flowers, but no, both the male and the female anatomy are together on the same flower. So the male anatomy is referred to as the stamen. It's made up of the anthers and the filaments that support them, okay? The anthers is where the pollen will be produced. The female part of the flower is the carpel, which is made up of the ovary at the bottom, which contains the ovules, and inside the ovules is where the ova will be. And then you've got the style up through the middle, and finally the stigma at the top. You've also got sepals, which are the little green leaves, which sort of cover the flower when it's in its bud stage. And you've got the petals there, which are used to attract the pollinators. This is the anatomy of a flower that is insect pollinated. Wind pollinated flowers have a different type of anatomy because they don't need to attract insects in the same way in order to distribute their pollen. The male gamete is called pollen, and it is produced in the anthers, as I mentioned, of the stamens. Each anther contains four pollen sacs where meiosis occurs to produce the haploid nuclei. So let's look at the process of microgametogenesis in more detail. So what you do is you start off with microspore mother cells, which are diploid cells. Now these divide by mitosis to produce four haploid microspores called a tetrad. Then an asymmetric division occurs by mitosis. This results in two distinct cells, a large tube cell and a small generative cell. The generative cell becomes engulfed within a membrane-bound compartment in the cytoplasm of the tube cell. So there are actually two haploid nuclei in the same cell. The pollen grains must be transferred from the anthers of a flower to the stigma in the process of pollination. If this occurs within the same flower, it's called self-pollination. If the pollen grains are transferred to a different flower, it's called cross-pollination. Now, pollination can occur by either the wind carrying the pollen or by an insect carrying the pollen from anther to stigma. When this happens, the generative nuclei divides once more by mitosis, so there are actually now three nuclei in the pollen grain after pollination has occurred. Now looking at the female gamete, that's the pollen taken care of. If we look at the female gamete, which is an egg cell or an ovum, these are contained within ovules inside an ovary. The ovule is attached to the wall of the ovary by placenta tissue. So in order to learn more about the embryo sac, we're going to look at megagametogenesis. You start off with megaspore mother cells, which are diploid. These divide by meiosis to produce four haploid megaspores. Three of these die and the other continues developing. It divides three times by mitosis to make an embryo sac with eight haploid nuclei, one of which is the egg cell, the megagamete. Three are what we call antipodal cells, two synergid and two polar nuclei. The next stage in sexually reproducing plants is for the male gamete to fuse with the female. Now this is called fertilisation. However, they are located quite far apart. The ovum is deep in the ovary and the pollen has landed on top of the stigma, which is right up on top of the style there, okay? So to transfer the gamete, the pollen grain has to grow a pollen tube which digests its way through the tissue of the style and into the ovary. It does this using the tube cell nucleus. So remember, first of all, we need pollination to occur. And remember that after pollination, the generative nucleus divides to make two nuclei. The pollen tube then nucleus digests its way down the style, forming a pollen growth tube. One of the generative nuclei fuses with the egg. The other fuses with the two polar nuclei. So fertilization in detail then. you've got that generative cell nucleus, which divides by mitosis to form two generative nuclei, okay? That's after pollination. Then the tube nucleus grows its pollen tube down the style by digesting it with enzymes. The generative nuclei then follow behind that tube nuclei, okay? The tube grows through the ovary and through the micropyle of an ovule. The two sperm pass into the ovule for fertilization, and one nucleus fuses as expected with the ovum to form a diploid zygote. The other, though, remember that two go in there, the other fuses with the two polar nuclei to form a triploid endosperm nucleus. Now this is used to supply the embryonic plant with food at germination. So this is how it makes its own food in the seed. Now this process is called double fertilization. We've got two fertilizations going on, really. We've got the first one there, which is the nucleus fusing with the ovum, which is the typical one we're expecting to fake a diploid zygote. Then we've got this second nucleus fusing with the two polar nuclei to make this triploid endosperm nucleus. That's the double fertilization.